All right, what we've got here is a mock-up of a roof. We're going to show you today the best solar roof there is. This kind of roof will power your entire house. You've got the plywood on the roof covered with PolyStick TU Plus, and it's a peel and stick product similar to Ice and Water Shield. We've got drip edge on the bottom already, and then up the gable we run our main cable and kind of stapled it in place. This is a metal shingle that is used in South Florida. You'll see it a lot in the Keys. It withstands all kinds of weather, winds, hurricanes, lasts a long time. What we've done is we've taken this Y out of it and this dimension down here and made it flat. And the reason we made it flat is because we put Unisolar solar film on it to make this type of roof, a solar roof that will produce electricity for your house. On the ends and the anywhere that need to be cut. The problem with the existing solar film for standing seam roofing, which is where this product is used now, is the anywhere that the solar part is not, or rather is, sticks out like a sore thumb. The rest of the roof is a different color. What we've done is anywhere that we can't use the solar or we don't need it, because you don't need solar on the entire roof. Just because, unless you want to produce electricity and sell it back to the power company. But anywhere you don't need it, we've got dummy shingles that have a film that looks exactly like it, but it does not have the, you don't need the expense of the silicone and all the wiring and whatnot that goes into the manufacture of the film that makes the film expensive. So anywhere that generally on a house, here's I'm installing. I'll show you what we've got is we just quick connect these wires together, and they're wired in series or parallel rather as they go out to the end. The main cable takes it up. Now this next shingle starts here. We've got a cut in half, that way it lands in the center of this one. This is a dummy shingle again. This has no wiring in it. It's not power producing electricity for you, but it looks exactly alike. Come along here, they just clip into one another. There's a little slot it slides into. The wiring is underneath right here where there's no screws or anything, and there's a little void behind the shingle made from the thickness of the film, and that way the wires are safe, they don't get squashed, everything is watertight. These last ones up here. Again, it connects to the main cable. The next starter shingle is again a dummy shingle. Then on the edge, we've got a piece of gable trim that goes up the edge. Now as you see, you start to see a pattern developed with the silver lines in between the solar film. What can be done there is that could be blue, black, or just left silver for a pattern. This gable trim is raised a little bit to hide the, keep the cable safe from being squashed and obviously out of the weather. The screws we use here are 5V screws. We have a rubber washer rod which seals down. Underneath here would be a butyl tape. I didn't put it on just for this. It would also keep the water from going over to the edges. This product on an average size house, about 40 square of roofing, you need about 8 square of solar to power your house, to keep your house completely powered. Have more of it, sell the power back to the power company. And then the other parts, the dummy shingles, this all can be done for less than the cost of a tile roof. You've got to put a roof on your house anyway, why not make it pay your electric bill?